Good morning, friends. It's 7 a.m. and I thought I'd show you what I'm having for breakfast. So I'm planning to make an omelet with two eggs, onion, green bell pepper, tomato, habanero, cilantro, some soyrizo, and then top it off with a bit of avocado. So this is really simple to make. I've been making this almost every day. I kind of switch up what kind of protein I use. Sometimes I use tuna, sometimes I use like other type of fake meat, but you can use whatever you want. We're gonna start by preheating the pan and then we're gonna prep our vegetables. I like to set the pan at about medium low, just under medium. I like to use about a quarter onion. And what I do is I store what I don't use in a Tupperware, that way I use it the next day. This was a big thing for me to figure out because I had these onions wrapped in foil in the fridge and I don't know how old they are, and now I just use the same onion day after day until it's gone, then I get a new one. I chop it in chunks. I don't need the pieces too small or too big. Whoops, careful your fingers. I probably could be doing this a little bit safer, but that'll be fine. Here is about less than half a tomato. I previously used a tomato for some slices to top on a burger. And in the past, again, I would just store tomatoes in foil and then they would go bad and it'd be gross and it'd go to waste. Now I put them in a Tupperware and everything's fine. So I'm gonna use everything here. So I'm gonna slice it up, kind of chunks, whatever size you want, it doesn't matter. Smaller than that. And now I'm gonna beat the eggs. Break these eggs. I'm gonna add a little bit of salt and pepper in there. Then I'm gonna loosely chop my cilantro. The cilantro is gonna go at the end because it'll wilt if you put it in the beginning. So I just chop it up loosely again. There's no real method to it. Just don't chop your fingers and you'll be fine. And then I like to use habanero for a little bit of kick. This one's starting to look a little sad and shriveled. So it's almost gonna be time to get new habaneros. You don't have to use them. You can use also jalapenos, serrano peppers. These are all great spicy boys if you like your food a little spicy. So I like to dice these really, really small. That way they're scattered throughout the omelet and I don't have like one big bite of spicy because that can be kind of painful. A little pain is okay, but too much, everyone has a threshold, right? I don't know if you can, yeah, you can see from here. Now do remember, after touching these habanero peppers, please wash your hands thoroughly and beware of cross-contamination as well. Everything you touch could potentially be cross-contaminated with spicy habanero, you know, whatever that substance is that makes it spicy. It is very irritant to the skin, specifically certain areas that are more sensitive than others, and I speak from experience, it is not fun. Luckily it doesn't last too long, it hurts for like 10-15 minutes and then it fades away, but be careful and wash your hands. Don't hurt yourself. Don't touch your eyes, too. Okay, we're all prepped up. Oh no, I forgot. my green pepper. I use about, depending on the size of the green pepper, either half of it or a third of it. So I'm gonna use, so I already used a third of it, so I'm gonna use another third, and I'll have, you know, another chunk to use for tomorrow, which will be fine. And this goes back in here. This can go in the fridge. As I cross-contaminate that container, and then later I'll probably touch my eyes and it'll be terrible, but oh well. I like to get rid of the white part of the green pepper. I'm not super precise about it, I don't really care, this is just for me. So depending on how picky you are, you can go ahead and be as thorough as you want. I just kind of do things as I wish. Okay, that's good enough. This. And I first cut these into strips, and then I cut the strips into little chunks, like so. Okay. And now we're gonna move over to the stove cam. Okay, welcome to the stove cam. We're gonna start by putting in a little bit of coconut oil. You can use butter, you can use any type of oil you want. I like coconut oil. It gives it a little coconut flavor. We've got coconut oil. I'm gonna put in the chorizo. It's actually soyrizo. So first goes in the soyrizo. You can put real chorizo, you can put, you know, tuna or whatever meat you want. Sausage, breakfast sausages or whatever. I know this doesn't look like the most appetizing thing coming out of a tube, but it's pretty good. Break it up in little pieces, swirl it around the oil, it's gonna sizzle a bit. I like to let it develop a little bit of a crust before adding anything else. It's not real meat, so you don't want to burn it, you don't want to overcook it. All right, this looks good. Now we're gonna add our onions. This piece could have been chopped up a little better. There we go. Our green pepper. Thank you. You want to let everything mingle, get to know each other, all the flavors mix, and it's going to be wonderful. I'm going to lower the heat a little bit. So you want to arrange all your ingredients kind of in a flat layer, so that when the egg comes in, you don't have any area where there's like too many ingredients together, because that means the egg's not gonna settle there, and then your omelet's gonna crumble. And I'm pretty sure the omelet's gonna crumble anyway, because this is kind of a large pan. I wish I had a smaller pan, that way the egg layer could be a bit thicker. But this is what I have, and I can make it work, so we'll be fine. Pour your egg mixture. Make sure to get everything in there. You don't want to waste anything. And then kind of move your pan around so that the egg coats evenly on the surface. You want a nice even layer. At this point, I like to add my tomatoes. Try to add them evenly as well. And I'll go in with the habanero as well. That'll also try to sprinkle as evenly as you can. You don't want like one area with all the habaneros. That happened to me once, and I took a bite and it was very spicy. It was still delicious though. Again, wash your hands after touching habaneros. Then you can kind of start poking at the sides. And if you notice that the sides aren't sticking, it means we're looking good. And then slowly start to kind of dig in there and make sure nothing's sticking. Just move things around. And shake the pan. Ooh, we got a good one. Oh. Yeah, this is looking good. So I'm gonna add my cilantro. We're just about done. And, oh, I had a plate, but I forgot it. All right, now we're gonna do a flip. This is where things can go south real quick. Yeah, already. So that's where my egg layer is really thin, because my pan is kind of large. So I can tell things are gonna crumble. I'm trying to get under there and flip. All right. Breakfast is ruined. No, it's fine. It's absolutely fine. It actually looks really good. I need more practice at this part. There's definitely a lot of room for improvement. But this is our omelet today, and it will be just fine. Ooh, and this is the part I often forget, topping with a little bit of avocado. Alright, and here is our breakfast. Let's give it a taste. It's very good. Alright. I hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully it inspires you to make your own omelet. Have a good day.